people, we're back inside the building. It's just gone 4 minutes past nine here on Trickstar Radio. Super excited to get into today's interview section. We are joined by an amazing artist, someone I've been looking forward to getting on for a long period of time, and one of the hottest names out there right now, especially considering some announcements that went down yesterday. Alakai Harley is on the line. How are you doing?
Hello, I'm feeling very blessed this morning, Kobe. How are you doing?
I'm good, man. I'm good. It's wicked to get you on the line. I can feel the energy right away.
Good. Thank you so much.
Awesome. Well, yeah, we've got loads of stuff to discuss, and obviously we've kind of had this interview locked in for a few weeks now, and I was scrolling through my Twitter feed yesterday, and I see this fantastic news about the Mobos, and obviously and yourself getting nominated for one. Do you want to talk me through how you kind of found out about what was happening?
Absolutely. First of all, like, I'm still in shock even this morning when I've woken up. Like, I woke up this morning and I still haven't been able to catch up with Twitter messages and everything. But I honestly found out from just opening my phone. Like, I literally woke up yesterday morning and I took the aeroplane, the Do Not Disturb off, you know, when you wake up?
Yeah, of course.
And the first thing I saw was a Twitter notification from the Mobos. And I was like, what? it just spun my head. It spun my whole head because we'll catch up with all of that, but that's how I found out anyway.
Amazing.
So, just, like, so phenomenal.
Literally, so you found out by them publicly tweeting you?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I was crying.
That's absolutely crazy. I mean, obviously, it's been quite a crazy year for yourself in regards to the sort of music you've been releasing, and something I'm really keen to kind of discuss as we move forward, obviously, is that sort of versatility. I've been talking about it all morning and why I'm so excited to get into it. But, like, is this something you expected to happen?
The Mobos?
Yeah.
Did I expect that to happen? Okay. Do you know what? Yeah. It's okay. The flesh me, the body me that walks around every single day, sometimes it feels a bit discouraging. Sometimes it's not sure. Just like everybody else is not sure what's going on. And if Mobos didn't even happen, so I didn't even think about it I didn't feel so hopeful about it. But in faith and my spirit wise, and when I'm praying, I still was praying about it. And I still, do you know what I mean, wanted 2020 to be that year, because this is something that me and my mates have talked about and my friends have talked about. So, yeah. I really didn't.
Amazing, man. Well, I think it's definitely really, really deserved, and it's why we were so excited to get you onto the show, because that's something we have been kind of already touching on, is that you've had an amazing year. You've had a lot of releases land in a lot of different areas of sound as well, and a lot of really interesting collaborations as well. So do you want to run for a few of the things that have happened specifically this year?
It's crazy because this is all this year. So DJ Zinc, Bubble, I've done Stoneboy Understand. Oh my gosh, it's really tough, isn't it? Cadenza, Up and R with Sham, all of that, MIA, Feelings, Jumomo, Omar, Awa.
I mean, this is the thing, the list
Kids,
is crazy.
Jumomo, again, and wow, and then obviously I was about a single, I just want to know,
I mean, it's crazy. When you look through the list, it is kind of crazy. And this is why it's not a surprise.
Oh, my gosh. Dizzy Rascal.
This is the...
Powers. Oh, my gosh. I didn't realise. Wow.
This is the thing. When you kind of sit back and look at it over the course of the year, it really is crazy. And this is why when I saw the awards kind of popping up, I was like, you know what? That makes perfect sense. I'm not even surprised, to be honest with you. And obviously something that kind of goes with that is, through these collaborations you've been doing over the course of the year, there's been so much sort of variation in sound and style. Yeah. Like, is that something you've always kind of done naturally, like move around?
Yeah. It actually has, and it's so crazy because now I'm thinking about it. As I just ruled them all out, they're all different. Wow, it's a part of my sound. Just kind of, I think all my fans kind of know that you don't really know what you're gonna get when I don't know what I'm gonna do. I really just enjoy music, and I can do it. So why not? I can do like all these different things, and they're actually me. So I just do it.
Yeah, definitely. Man.
But I love trying to explore. You know what I mean? A new sound.
Definitely.
I'm trying to find time.
I think the interesting thing with your sound as well is there are obviously so many different areas to it. And if we look at the difference, for instance, between, say, I Just Want to Know and Bubble, like for me, two of my favourite tunes of this year, two tunes we've been absolutely smashing here on the show. And you look at the kind of difference, like, do you go about the sort of writing process and the recording process any differently, or is it the same for you?
It is a different, it's kind of the same, but it's kind of different. It's really dope because what I love is... is going into other people's worlds. And I'm always very open to that. So like when I'm in the studio with DJ Zinc, it's different from when I'm in the studio and I'm in a studio with Stoneboy. I can let it guide me. Do you know what I mean? I like letting it be a thing where I'm coming into someone else's world and I kind of bring my touch at me into it, if that makes sense. So I feel like all the writing processes are going to be different whether I like them or not.
Yeah,
just slightly.
That makes sense, man. That really makes sense. And obviously, the interesting thing about this is you've worked with some legends this year, some genuine kind of some kind of pillars of different sounds from obviously Dizzy, just in UK grime and rap in general, like across the board, he's been one of the real pillars. And then even in the dance music world, DJ Zinc, who is obviously a kind of legend in what he does in a lot of different genres as well. How was it kind of stepping into that dance music world?
I think it was for a minute before it's actually come out. So I guess when I first did it, it's just like when you do something for the first. It wasn't the first time I was doing that. Because it's probably very clear. To be honest, I've always kind of played. There's always going to be stuff that people haven't heard that you do by yourself. But I guess when I was coming, for me, when I was going into the studio with DJ Zinc beforehand, I did want to, you know what I mean? You want to do the most because this guy's had his hits and, you know, all that stuff and he knows how to do this. So I did kind of want to create my best, but I guess it just happened. I don't know. It comes naturally, innit? Like, I did feel like, I don't know, because obviously I go in there as a normal human being, like, as anyone else thinking, okay, this is not really my world, but I'm going to kill it. And I guess... That's just what it is.
Yeah, definitely, man. When you actually sit back and look through like how good the range is, it's something that always makes me very, very, very interested in an artist is that ability to kind of take their sound across different sounds. Yeah. And it's definitely something that's really, really worked for you so far, I feel. What I want to kind of do now, we're going to move forward slightly and talk about another tune we have mentioned, which is I Just Want to Know. So talk to me about this tune and how it came together, because this one seems to have done absolute bits.
Thank you so much. First of all, I Just Want to Know has been one of my favorite songs for so long. I wanted that song to come out, like, and it's so crazy because I think in the industry a lot of people obviously knew the song, but it's just like just with fans to hear and everything. But it was just like when was it recorded? 2018 September times, I think. No, 100%. 2018 September times, and I think it was 2 days after my birthday. We was in the studio, me and Wild Boy Ace and my other friends and SSK, and we're just all in the studio because I think prior to that I had a birthday studio session, something like that. And then he just put on the beat, and when he put on the beat, like, it was supposed to be a studio session party, and then I just started rapping, and then I started writing it. But that one was a quick one. When I tell you, it was like, it's always those quick ones, though, because Gold was a very quick write, and I think it's because I wrote off of real experiences, because I was kind of writing, I Just Want to Know, for just relationship and off of my morals and actually real situation that I've actually had, you know what I mean? And, we just kind of did it. The sample was originally there with the Ashanti's original vocals, and we just played around with that and edited that over time, and I just really enjoy that song. But that is all created by Anti-Wave. But obviously, Ace was the person that was in the studio initially when I recorded it.
Amazing, man. I mean, so kind of moving forward with it. The whole process of it sounds super, super interesting. And that sort of group studio environment as well. Is that something you prefer to be in rather than just kind of rolling solo?
No, not really. You know, most of the time I do roll solo. But do you know what? Like I said, I really enjoy music. So that actual session and around that time, it was a birthday studio session. It was the year that I'd had a birthday party in the studio. I was in the studio lockdown. Like, I was enjoying it. This was life. So it was a thing where the reason why my Britons were all there is because, well, I wasn't going out, innit? So this is where I was coming. This is just a vibe. It wasn't like by force that I had to be recording. But I guess because I was flowing. Now when I look at it in hindsight, my manager was just probably realizing I was flowing, so it didn't really matter. You know what I mean? Like, party in the studio, let's go, because she's working. So it's that. But I didn't clock it at the time. But that's what it is. I was just flowing, innit? So just like, yeah.
And it came from there. Awesome, man. Well, it's a sick story for how it's kind of come together. We're going to get into this tune now, and obviously from there we're going to move into a bit more of a chat about the future for yourself, like what we can expect along the way. One time, just whilst we're on the line and we've got you here, what is the best way for people to get hold of you on different social media platforms, because I know you're quite active?
For all my fans, everybody, you can get hold. I'm here on Twitter, Instagram. Like, I'm stuck in it. I'm here on Facebook as well. I'm everything Alikai Harley, A L I C A I H A R L E Y. But I'm mostly on Instagram and Twitter are like, yeah.
Wicked. Well, there we go. We're going to get into this one now then. It's just gone 13 minutes past nine here. We are live on Trickstar Radio at Cub KXVU at Trickstar BTN. The wonderful Alakai Harley is on the line with us this morning. Make sure you stick around and don't go anywhere, people. It's Trickstar.
Breakfast with Cub Colvin.
Trickstar Radio.